Cat Synth TV. Hey everybody, Cat Synth TV, and today we are looking back at the legacy of Little Richard, who passed away today. Richard Wayne Penniman was born in Macon, Georgia, into a very conservative Christian family. A naturally musical child, he was steeped in the music of the Black Church. As Chuck Berry brought R&B and country into early rock and roll, so Little Richard brought the sound and style of gospel music. He also flattened the rhythmic pattern of R&B from a shuffle to straight eights and presented the driving two-handed piano style that would be his signature. Alongside the church, it is also important to recognize the influence of his early sexuality and identity as a Black gay man in the 1950s. He was from an early age an effeminate boy, a characteristic that earned him frequent mocking from his peers and ultimately got him kicked out of his home. He explained, "My daddy put me out of the house. He said he wanted seven boys, and I had spoiled it because I was gay." After meeting Billy Wright, he began to adopt his signature look with makeup and his pompadour hairstyle and flamboyant costumes and stage presence. Indeed, his style would go on to influence James Brown with his own signature pompadour and flamboyant costumes. His musical influence was strong as well. There is, of course, the story of James Brown, who was opening for Penniman at the time, discovering a discarded napkin of Penniman's with the words, "Please, please, please." And we know where that went. As Brown moved into his funky sound of the 1970s, the sound which made him one of my great musical heroes, we see cross-pollination and Brown's influence back to his mentor on tracks like Freedom Blues, a part of Penniman's work that I feel is underappreciated. But perhaps the influence of his style and persona can most be seen in Prince. The androgynous persona, the purple and bedazzled costuming, and the hair all trace directly to Little Richard. We can also hear Penniman's piano style woven into Prince's guitar, along with Hendrix and Sly and the Family Stone, whose own presentations channel Penniman's visual style. Do you have any memories or thoughts about Little Richard, his influence on music and culture? Please let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Check out more at www.catsynth.com, and please subscribe to Cat Synth TV.